Hey! Hi guys, how's it going? Gee whiz, good to see you again. Listen, I have to apologize to you. I know I promised you Toronto Mount Pleasant Cemetery. Unfortunately, due to time constraints, work, and getting sick, I didn't get a chance to get there this year. But we are definitely going in the spring, and hopefully before all the leaves are on the trees. Oops, sorry. Before all the leaves get on the trees, because that way you can see all the headstones much better, because there's just so many trees there. But the video I'm going to do today for you is actually related to Mount Pleasant Cemetery. It's basically how Mount Pleasant got its start, and so did the Necropolis Cemetery. And it's actually very interesting because I bet most Torontonians who go by the intersection of Yonge and Bloor every day, and it's a major intersection in the city of Toronto, have no clue. No clue whatsoever that this at one time was a huge cemetery, a burial ground. It was known as York Burial Grounds and then renamed Toronto Burial Grounds after 1834 when the city of Toronto was incorporated, but is also known as Strangers Burial Ground, aka Potter's Field. And it was the first non-denominational burial ground in the town of York, then, of course, the city of Toronto. Now, Yorkville is one of the most trendiest areas in the city of Toronto. I can remember, you know, as a younger person, my sister and I would go down on a Saturday for brunch. We'd take the subway into Toronto and we'd go wander around the bistros, have coffee, lunch. We'd walk into the boutiques. We go to the private studios. I mean, it is one where all the hippies, the yuppies, and the hipsters, and everybody hangs out in Yorkville. And it's still a great place to go to this day. But it was a huge burial ground. It had something like 9,000 people buried in that area. So what happened to it? Well, a little bit of history. Back in 1825, the burial ground was first established for burying the dead of the town of York. And it was located where the intersections of Yonge and Bloor Street now intersect. Actually, it was on the northwest side of the intersection. Now, which is actually the actual heart of Yorkville. It saw business up until the mid-1850s, and around that time, it was starting to get pretty damn full. I mean, there had been a few epidemics, stuff like that. So, you know, it was starting to get beyond its capacity. Now, basically, the people that were interred there were people who didn't have any religious belief or didn't prescribe to any religious belief. There was also the destitute were interred there. Even some of the criminal were interred there. Unwed mothers, I hate to say it, were interred there if they died in childbirth, and if their children were stillborn, were buried there as well. It was basically a dumping ground of anyone that could not be buried on consecrated ground. You see, back then in Toronto, if you weren't Roman Catholic or Church of England, you're basically SOL when it came to being buried in a cemetery, unless you lucked out and had a private family plot somewhere on one of the farms in the area or wherever. You were relegated to the Potter's Field. And I don't know what it is about Potter's Field. It just drums up some really negative connotations. And most of the people that were buried there, it was through no fault of their own. It's because either they didn't have any financial means, or, you know, because they were strangers to the city of Toronto. People didn't know about them, whether they had a religious belief or whether they belonged to the local Catholic Church or Church of England. They didn't know. So they buried him in these pot in this potter's field. And for the most part, it really wasn't well taken care of. It was a potter's field. It was basically a piece of ground that at the time wasn't good for anything else other than burying people. And that's what they did. And you know, if you were lucky, the deceased had maybe friends of the next of kin that looked after the graves. Otherwise, it wasn't maintained. It was just an area where people were buried. A lot of graves were unmarked. They're unclaimed bodies buried there. I mean, you name it. It was kind of a hodgepodge of individuals who lived in the city. Who had come to the city to fulfill their dream in the new world, and this is where they ended up. Well, by about the 1850s, the city of Toronto thought, you know, we need to do better. We need to establish proper Victorian garden cemeteries. They were really starting to take off around the 1850s, 1840s, 1850s over in the United Kingdom. And of course, here in Upper Canada, thought, well, why can't we do the same thing? They're much nicer. You know, a place where anyone can be buried. Doesn't matter how rich you were, how poor you were, what your religion was, what your ethnicity was, you know, didn't matter. If you could buy a plot, you could be buried there. So in 1850, the Necropolis Cemetery, which is not a little further south, east of Toronto Mount Pleasant, was established. And there was over 5,000 exhumations from the old potter's field taken and became the first burials in Necropolis Cemetery. And the ones that were taken to Necropolis, the ones that they knew could be, were identified, and also the ones where either the families had chosen to reinter their loved ones there, or either they did it themselves or they had the city do it for them. They had a choice when the notice went out. You could either take your loved ones to the Necropolis Cemetery, or the ones that could be identified, the city would do it as well for you. Now, after about 1855, when they technically had closed down the Potter's Field, they weren't doing any more burials there, and they had taken, you know, over 5,000 interments over to Necropolis. This left about 3,000 and change still in the ground over in Yorkville, and it stayed that way for 20 years. And the reason why it did, because these were the burials that were unmarked and unknown or unclaimed. So the city of Toronto left them there in hopes that somebody would come forward and claim their loved ones and they could take them over. Eventually, they had to disinter everybody and take them somewhere, you know, and have them buried. And by then, we were now in the 1870s. So, of course, in 1876 was when Toronto Mount Pleasant was established, was opened, after 3 years of planning and landscaping. And they decided that the first burials there would be the remaining interments that were left in the old strangers' burial ground. So they were moved and taken over to Mount Pleasant. So they got about 3,500 exhumations and reburials there. Now, in both cemeteries, the remains were placed into a mass grave. And they are marked with memorials and headstones that are from the original burial grounds. And if you go into the cemetery, you can actually go and see some of these headstones. Usually they're very, they've got very early dates on them, anything from 1823 to about probably 1840-ish, early 1850, very early 1850s, but late 1840s. You'll see those dates. If there are no cemeteries, then basically you know that they have come from the old York burial ground, aka the Strangers burial ground, aka Potter's Field. So the next time that you're in the city of Toronto, Toronto the Good there, and you're enjoying your espresso or latte down in Yorkville, just remember where you're sitting. That's right. right in the middle of an old cemetery. And now and then, just now and then when there's a construction project, sometimes human remains show up, and which tells you they didn't quite get everybody out. Yeah. So, okay. Yorkville, place to be. Don't forget. It's an old cemetery. Yeah, one of those places. Kind of fascinating, isn't it? Yeah. There is this plaque down there somewhere near Bloor and Young that it's dedicated to the pioneers of the area. And if you ever get down there, you know, try and read it. And just remember what it would used to be. Yeah, old cemetery. Who'd have guessed, eh? Anyway, thanks very much for listening. If you like the channel, please like and subscribe. This is YouTuber killing me. They really are making it difficult. I think my videos are just as good as the next person that goes graveyard exploring. And as something else comes up, we'll put up a video. And I do promise you in the spring, we will get to Toronto, Mount Pleasant. Because I really want to go down there and have a look at some of those mausoleums. That'll be such a great trip. All right, this is Sharon saying, you know the rules. Please be respectful. Take only pictures, leave only footprints. Until the next video. Bye for now.